already light inside these crystals.
You're right. Normally, we'd have to provide our own. Perhaps slotting a crystal on the opposite side could shed some light on this mystery.
I knew you were going to say that.
It was hidden for some time. Perhaps now it can serve as a reminder.
Aye. Nothing reminds people of their history like chiseled, well-lit marble.
The ring of crystal shards is glowing now.
Looks like we can read the inscription now as well. In honor of the Enlightened One, may his gift of light shine eternal. Ah, gift of light.
Light from the crystals. It is in the sand now.
Would you look at that? Freyr's gift endures after all. Or should I say, his presence?
You are not funny.
brother. Do you think there will ever be peace in Alphon?
Peace is difficult after centuries of conflict. It must be found in its own time, from within. It cannot be forced.
Your mom helped you find peace, right? How are the elves supposed to change if no one shows them the way?
Your mother. She trusted me. Gave me the space to find my own way. But you are right, Atreus. She was my guide. Our actions in Alphon may not bring peace. But by ending the storm and bringing light back to this land, perhaps we have planted the seeds.
Couldn't have said it better myself. Sounds like I'm rubbing off on you, brother.
It is.
Returning to my anecdote about the Heath Witches, they fed the Thane a prophecy of his ascension to king. They dressed it up in enough details they knew would come to pass, so when they did, the Thane took it as confirmation.
Set that aside for now. Come.
For the massive door we found earlier.
That door required two keys.
Aye, so it did. Let's keep looking then. Returning to my anecdote about the Heath Witches, they fed the Thane a prophecy of his ascension to king. Next thing you know, he's helping matters along. He murders his king, sleeping under his own roof.
No more for now. Focus.
Welcome.
Am I right in getting the sense you've actually gotten to know Thor's daughter somewhat?
Yeah, dude's great. Wants to be a Valkyrie one day. She deserves to be. Of course, I told her all about the Valkyries we faced. But I'm not sure how much she believes me. It didn't feel great when I tried to tell her stories about her grandfather, though.
Anyone can have a blind spot when it comes to family.
So... Hold on. Prepare for battle. Another berserker gravestone.
Yalti the stolid!
The king!
Nasty hit! No. You all right, brother?
No, you are mine! Wait! Expected more!
This is a fine mess!
God!
Another berserker gravestone.
Go!
Kafka!
Perhaps we can bring these two animals back to Vanaheim, or Midgard even. Becky and Svanna could use the company. We have kennels.
I don't know. They feel pretty happy here. Alfheim is their home.
I suppose you're right. It just seems lonely out here.
It is peaceful. They have each other. It is enough.
Kafka!
to take out those springs, brother!
brothers. How did you manage to kill Garm anyway?
We killed him a few times, actually, but it didn't take. And I figured maybe the way to stop a soulless beast was to give it a soul. So I gave it the one I had on me.
I beg your pardon?
Fenrir. Remember the light Father saw? The accidental magic I did when Fenrir died? That was part of Fenrir's soul going into my knife. Figured that out, I just put Fenrir into Garm.
Clever one, lad! A gigantic hell beast with the soul of a loyal pup. Bloody brilliant!
Something ain't you back there. Whoa! Is that a Drake? Something angry back there. Whoa! Is that a Drake? Time to move!
Mine, imprisoning a Drake. Can't decide whether to be impressed or horrified.
Either way, it is over now.
Like Freyr's carved into it. Maybe it's for good luck, or for use in prayer.
Do you know Garm? How was he locked up to begin with?
Ah, Hell's Feral Sentinel. But believe it or not, Midgard was once bigger. Until Garm, then just a wee pup, got peckish.
He ate Midgard?
Only a few mountain ranges. And the fifth season that comes after winter but before spring. And a word for the feeling when you get so hungry, you stop being hungry.
You're messing with me.
I would never. That's a fair few birds you've hunted. I wonder if it might be worth visiting the Raven Tree. Back to my story. A thane of my homeland, manipulated by prophecy, welcomes his king as a guest and murders him in his sleep. Murders many he once called friends, too, thinking them fated to oppose him.
Enough talk for now. Be ready.
Father's new spear. It's made out of a ring?
Dropped near aye. Forged by the Huldra brothers as a gift for Odin.
How's it work?
Every so often, the Dropnir drips out identical copies of itself. The Huldras presumably figured that if one golden ring was a good gift, an infinite number of them would earn them a permanent place in Odin's heart.
But it didn't.
Not even a little. Destroying the ravens free their spirits somehow. Good to know.
Free?
Well, free of Odin's control, anyway.
We told what we saw, empowered his lies. Good little ravens. Good little spies.
Ra, when you knew Faye, was she...
Let me stop you right there, killer. Brock ain't one to go breaking no confidences. Not even when it comes to the dearly departed. You don't hear me spreading your business all over town, do you? Smiths don't blab. It's just how it's gotta be.
Travel to Vanaheim.
Great. Gonna check in on Freya?
Yes.
Glad I get to come this time. So what happened the last time you were in Vanaheim? Still don't know how you got Freya to stop trying to kill you.
We traveled to her village to break Odin's spell. Once freed, she accepted that I was not her enemy.
You also missed a highly entertaining moment where Brock was lifted arse over face in Freyr's camp.
You met Freyr? What's he like?
Different from his sister. Lacks her conviction.
True. And he's a bit quicker to forgive.
And an ineffective leader.
But his heart's in the right place. You'll like him, lad.
beautiful. And, wet.
It is also dangerous.
More dangerous than hell?